What's up guys, Minecraft and Fraps back again with another video. I just finished recording something and I just wanted to show you guys how I edit the audio to make it sound nice. So the first thing you want to do when you're trying to sync audio and video is have some sharp sound in order to sync it up. So as you can see right here, I have a sort of, I clap. So let me play that for you and you can listen. So that's the clap, and I clapped in the frame of the video, and I can hear it in the audio so I can sync up everything else. When I start at the beginning, as you can see, when there shouldn't be any noise up here in the waveform, there is actually noise, and that's called background noise. So I'm going to show you guys how to remove that and how to make your audio sound better. So what you want to do, make sure you have enough space to select. So I selected the first 3 seconds, and I'm going to go to Effect. Noise removal, get noise profile. And what that does is identify that entire section as noise that you want to remove from the video. And then what I do is hit Control A or select the entire clip, effect, noise removal, and okay. And so what that does, what that's gonna do right now is remove all of that noise that I don't want from the audio source that I'm going to put in my video, and it makes it sound a little bit nicer. Of course, we're going to delete that entire first segment because I don't want that clap inside of my video. But when I go back here, start from the beginning and play, there's absolutely nothing in the waveform when it's playing, you know, empty sound, which is how it should be. So now when I go back and play,
what's up guys, Minecraft and Fraps back again with another awesome video.
My voice is a lot clearer than it usually would be. I'm going to do the same thing for this video as well. Unfortunately, I can't tell you because I'm recording right now, but that's the basic premise behind it. Another thing you want to do if you're doing voiceovers like I am is select everything, hit Effect, and hit Normalize. And what this does is lower the peaks over here. So you can see these peaks are kind of close to just cutting off. And that's when you lose data. That's when the audio starts sounding really bad. So I usually just leave it as at -1 decibels, hit okay. And what that's gonna do, and you'll see in the waveform as well, is kind of compress the waveform a little bit. It just did that. And it reduces kind of the difference between the highs and the lows, makes it sound a little bit better. Another thing you wanna do is select everything, Control A, and go up here to compressor. And what that's gonna do is equalize between different segments of your audio. So I'm gonna hit okay. It's gonna go through that. And as you see, the waveform is gonna become a little bit smoother. So we'll just wait for that to go on. And having a smoother waveform just means better audio. It's gonna sound better. It's gonna sound crisper, that sort of stuff. So 2 seconds it should be until we get to where we need to be. And there we go. Okay, so as you can see, it kind of equalized the audio. The peaks did get a little bit bigger, but as long as nothing is touching these top or bottom lines and we know nothing is clipping and we're not losing any data, I'm perfectly fine. So now this audio source is ready to be exported. So what I do is File, Export. And I have folders for everything. So I go in here, I don't have, you know, a folder for what I'm doing right now because it's a software tutorial. But what I would do is save it in here. I'm just gonna save it in my YouTube files folder and save it as tutorial file. And it's gonna save as .wav. And then what I do is bring it into my video editor, sync up all the audio, and then we're good to go. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit save. Artist name, so Minecraft and Fraps. Track title, tutorial. Album, so you know, you can do all that sort of stuff. I'm gonna leave all this stuff blank because it's just kind of useless information that no one really looks at, and you can change afterwards if you want to do something like that. So that's good. It's gonna export. And then that audio will, like I said earlier, go into my video editor. Then we can sync up all the audio with the video and I can get a video out to you guys. So that's all for this short tutorial. Thank you guys for watching. Make sure to subscribe. Comment down below if you have any sort of questions like this, so I know you guys are really looking for these kind of videos or any other kind of video. Visit my channel, do whatever you want, share it with your friends, blah, blah, blah. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.